was in Newfoundland late 1989. We lived surrounded by forest and we liked it just fine. You could hear your neighbors talking when you picked up the phone. Needless to say, you were never alone. People came out of their houses during the day, spent time with their families, grew their own food, fished or hunted, and we liked it that way. During the night is when we turned on TV, we erected our antennas. As for channels, there were three. Close attention was paid to the news from outside, material for tomorrow's gossip. Adults chatted across their fences or cheerful with pride. As a tiny young girl, I would sit in the grass and stare at the sky to make the time pass. I did have a shovel. I sure loved to dig for worms, and in the air there was always a chip. One day I reeled up out of the ground on my own a triangular-shaped, little white human bone. Put my nose down. Apparently my voice exclaimed. I replied, "Where is you two? What's your father's name?" Suddenly the hole sucked up all of the dirt that I worked hard to dig with the sound of a fart. The grass instantly grew back and covered the mound. "Hello?" I screamed, but there was nobody there to be found. I kept the bone in my pocket throughout all of the day. I was afraid that somebody might throw it away. Later I felt movement in my pocket so wild. A voice screamed, "Give me my nose back, you brat of a child." I then in that moment knew that I had angered a ghost. I unzipped my pocket and out the bone flew. It hit the front door. A pirate then materialized. He looked like a relative too. He picked up the nose bone as he flipped me the bird. Never again was the ghost, by me, seen or heard.